Yes, trade receivable turnover ratio is one of very important activity ratio. The purpose of activity ratio is to check the operational efficiency of the business, isn't it? More the ratio, better the condition. What this ratio tells? See, you can see the formula. Trade receivable turnover ratio is equal to net credit sales upon average trade receivables. Upon average trade receivables. This is the formula, and whatever comes we write in times. We use to express times. This ratio, trade receivable turnover ratio. More the ratio, better the condition. If it comes 3 times, if it comes 4 times, if it comes 5 times, more the times, better the condition of the business. It means that 5 times company is able to generate sales in a year. If ratio comes 6 times, it means company is able to generate sales 6 times. If it comes 10 times, it means company is able to generate sales 10 times in 1 year. So more the ratio, better the condition. If company is able to generate more sales in 1 year, it means the company's operational efficiency is very good. So this is what it means, trade receivable turnover ratio, net credit sales upon average trade receivable. So let us begin with the numerical, question number 85. Okay. Question number 85. Credit revenue from operation, that is net credit sales, which is given 12 lakh. Debtors are given 1,20,000 and bills receivables are given 80,000. Calculate trade receivable turnover ratio. Okay. So in this question, net credit sales is given 12 lakh. Debtors and bills receivable are given. Debtors and bills receivable are given 1,20,000 and 80,000. Very simple, So the formula of trade receivable turnover ratio is, trade receivable turnover ratio is net credit sales upon average trade receivable. Net credit sales is given directly 12 lakh, so we can write 12 lakh. How do we calculate average trade receivable? Opening plus closing divided by 2. This is the formula of average trade receivable. Opening trade receivable plus closing trade receivable divided by 2. But in this question, opening and closings, it is not given. Only debtor and bills receivable is mentioned here. Opening debtor and opening bills receivable, closing debtor and closing bills receivable, in this manner it is not given. So we will consider it as a closing debtor and closing bills receivable. When opening is not given, only closing is given, then we do not use this formula, then we do not divide it by 2, because 2 values are not given separately of opening and closing. So 1,20,000 plus 80, 2 lakh. Is that clear? Because opening is not given, so that's why we do not divide it, and we will consider it as a average trade receivable. So 12 lakh divided by 2 lakh, it will be 6 times. What does it mean 6 times? 6 times means company is able to generate sales 6 times in 1 year. I hope it is clear to everyone. Let's see one more question. Question number 86. Question number 86. Calculate trade receivable turnover ratio from the following information. Here you can see opening and closing balances are given. Debtors, bills receivable, provision for doubtful debts. Total sales is given, sales return is given, and cash sales is given. What is needed? Net credit sales, yes or no? to calculate trade receivable turnover ratio, we need net credit sales upon average trade receivable. Okay, so we need to calculate how to calculate. You can see net credit sales is required, and here it is total sales which is given. So what we do to calculate credit sales, total sales is given in the question. Out of total sales, we will subtract sales return and cash sales. Minus sales return minus cash sales. So what we get? Net credit sales. Simple. Total sales is given 1 lakh. Sales return 1500. And cash sales is 23,500. 23,500. So 1 lakh minus 25,000, 75,000 is your net credit sales. Is that clear? Now we need to calculate average trade receivable, and we know that opening trade receivable plus closing trade receivable divided by 2 is the formula of average trade receivable. So we can calculate average trade receivable in this manner. Opening trade receivable means debtors and bills receivable. These are opening trade receivable. So 28 plus 7. Provision for doubtful debt is also given. But children, while calculating trade receivable turnover ratio, we do not consider provision for doubtful debt. Okay? Why we do not consider? Because our purpose is to check exact efficiency to generate sales. And this is our internal arrangement, 1500. 4500, है ना? If we subtract provision for doubtful debts, what will happen? We are not able to calculate the exact efficiency of the business in generating sales. That's why we do not deduct this provision for doubtful debt. Remember. Okay, so opening trade receivable means 28 plus 7. 28,000 plus 7,000. This is the opening trade receivable. Then plus closing trade receivable. 25 plus 15, 25,000 plus 15,000 closing trade receivable divide by 2. So average trade receivable is equal to 28 plus 7, 35,000, 25 plus 15, 40,000. Divide by 2. So 75,000 divide by 2, it will be 37,500. Yes or no? So this is your average trade receivable, and net credit sales we have already computed. So we will put in the formula 75,000 net credit sales upon 37,500. So trade receivable turnover ratio will be 2 times. It means in 1 year business is able to generate sales 2 times. So I hope the question is clear to everyone. Let's solve one more question. Question number 87. Okay, question number 87. Closing trade receivables are given 90,000. Closing trade receivables are given 90,000. Revenue from operation is given 720,000. Revenue from operation is given 720,000. Cash revenue from operation is 180,000, means cash sales 180,000. Provision for doubtful debts 8,000. We do not require it, do not consider it. Calculate trade receivable turnover ratio. We need to calculate trade receivable turnover ratio, and trade receivable turnover ratio means नेट क्रेडिट सेल्स अपॉन एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल. ओके, सो रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन इज गिवन एंड क्रेडिट सेल्स इज गिवन, कैश सेल्स इज गिवन. सो व्हाट वी डू, वी सबट्रैक्ट कैश सेल्स. व्हाट वी गेट क्रेडिट सेल्स. तो 7,20,000 माइनस 1,80,000, 5,40,000, यस और नो? 7,20,000 माइनस 1,80,000, 5,40,000. सो नेट क्रेडिट सेल्स इज 5,40,000 वी हैव कंप्यूटेड, एंड ओनली क्लोजिंग ट्रेड रिसीवेबल इज गिवन, ओपनिंग इज नॉट गिवन. सो दिस क्लोजिंग ट्रेड रिसीवेबल विल बी कंसीडर्ड एज एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल, 90,000. Yes or no? 9, 6, 54. It means the ratio will be 6 times. I hope it is clear to everyone. It is very simple. Hai na? Is it clear? Any doubt to anyone? I hope there is no doubt.
No, sir.
Yes. Let's move on next question. Question number 88. Please note it down. Hai na? It is very simple. Question number 88. Question number 88. Closing trade receivable is given 1 lakh. Closing trade receivable is given 1 lakh. Cash sales is 25% of credit sales. Okay. So suppose credit sales, we suppose, is X. If credit sales is X, cash sales is 25% of X. So 25% of X means X by 4. You know, cash sales will be X by 4. Excess of closing trade receivable over opening trade receivable is 40,000. Okay. And closing trade receivable is already given 1 lakh. It means opening trade receivable is 40,000 less than closing. So it will be 1 lakh minus 40,000 is equal to 60,000. So opening trade receivable will be 60,000. And one more information is given, net revenue from operation, that is net sales. Net sales is given 6 lakh. So these are the information which are given. We need to calculate trade receivable turnover ratio. So trade receivable turnover ratio formula is net credit sales upon average trade receivable. Now in the given question, the net sales is given, cash sales is given, and credit sales is given. We need to calculate credit sales. Okay, so children, as we know that a credit sale plus cash sale is equal to total sales, yes or no? Cash sales plus credit sales, or credit sales plus cash sales, is equal to total sales. So how much credit sale is given? X we have taken. X. How much cash sales will be? Cash sales will be X by 4. Is equal to total sales. Total sales is given 6 lakh. So by this equation we can easily calculate credit sales, hai na? So X plus X by 4 will be 5X by 4 is equal to 6 lakh. And when we cross multiply it, what we get? X is equal to 4 into 6 lakh divide by 5. So 5, 12 ja 60, 12, 4 ja 48, 4 lakh 80,000, It means what is X? X is credit sale. So credit sale we have computed will be 480,000. What is needed? Average trade receivable is needed. Okay, let's calculate average trade receivable also. Average trade receivable means opening trade receivable plus closing trade receivable divided by 2, and both are given in this question. है ना, ओपनिंग ट्रेड रिसीवेबल इज 1 lakh, क्लोजिंग सॉरी ओपनिंग इज गिवन 60 एंड क्लोजिंग इज 1 lakh. सो 60,000 प्लस 1 lakh डिवाइड बाय 2, इट विल बी 1,60,000 डिवाइड बाय 2, 80,000. सो 80,000 इज अवर एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल. Let us put these two values in formula, 4,80,000 and 80,000 in net credit sales. 4,80,000 divided by 80,000. 8, 6, 48. Yes. So it will be 6 times. I hope it is clear to everyone. So I hope question number 88 is clear to everyone. Let's move on another question. Question number 89. Question number 89. From the following particulars determine trade receivable turnover ratio. Revenue from operation is given. Credit revenue from operation is given and trade receivable is given. So children, in this question directly the values are given. Credit sales is given directly, no need to calculate, 16 lakh, and trade receivable is given 2 lakh. Opening and closing is not given, it means it is closing, so we consider this trade receivable as average trade receivable, hai na? And trade receivable turnover ratio we can calculate here only. Net credit sales 16 lakh divided by trade receivable. This is average trade receivable because opening and closing both are not given. Only trade receivable is mentioned, it means it is closing. So we will consider it as a average trade receivable 2 lakh. When we divide it, what we get? 8 times. I hope it is clear to everyone. 8 times. It means the company's operational efficiency is very good. More the ratio, better the condition. है ना?
Sir?
Yes?
No sir, nothing sir.
हाँ, ask, बोलो.
Sir, actually, I thought it is net credit sales is given 6 lakh. Actually,
16 lakh.
Was yes, sir, yes. Sir. It is
16 lakh.
Okay,
so let's move on next question. Question number 90. Question number 90. Compute trade receivable turnover ratio from the following. Revenue from operation is given 8 lakh. Debtors in the beginning is given. Debtors at the end is given and sales return is given. Children, here we do not consider sales return. We do not take sales return anywhere because net sales is given. And net sales means sales minus sales return. Sales minus sales return is equal to net sales. It means in this 8 lakh and in this 7 lakh, sales return is already deducted. Do you understand? Is that clear to everyone? So sales return we do not use here, hai na? Only average for opening debtor and closing debtors we will take definitely. So let me continue. Trade receivable turnover ratio for 2020 and 21. Trade receivable turnover ratio means net credit sales upon average trade receivable. Now in this question you can see revenue from operation is given and credit revenue from operation is not given, है ना? Credit sales is not given, only net sales is given. But in this question there is no way to calculate credit sales, and it is not mentioned that this net sales is in this net sales cash sales is included. Nothing is mentioned. So when we are not able to calculate net credit sales, this net sales will be considered as net credit sales. Am I clear to everyone? Okay. So for 2020, first I will calculate for 2020 trade receivable turnover ratio. So this sales will be considered as net credit sales. Hello? Because we are not able to calculate credit sales with the given information. So the sales which is given will be considered as credit sales also. So 8 lakh average trade receivable means opening plus closing divided by 2. So 83 plus 1,17,000 means 2 lakh. 2 lakh divided by 2, 1 lakh. Directly I am calculating. So it will come 8 times. Okay, opening plus closing divided by 2, and here for 2021 trade receivable turnover ratio, net credit sales 7 lakh and average trade receivable opening plus closing divided by 2, so 1,17,000 plus 83, 2 lakh divided by 2, 1 lakh. So 7 lakh divided by 1 lakh will be 7 times. Hai na? Very simple. I hope there is no doubt to anyone, hai na, in these questions. Let's move on another question. Question number 91. Closing trade receivable is given 1,20,000. Closing trade receivable is given 1,90,000. Revenue from operation is given 14,40,000. Means net sales is given 14,40,000. Provision for doubtful debt is 20,000. We do not consider provision for doubtful debt, isn't it? When we calculate trade receivable turnover ratio, calculate trade receivable turnover.
The closing ratio. Trade receivables are 1,20,000.
Ah, no, 1,20,000. Acha, yes, 1,20,000. Closing trade receivables are, yes, correct. It is 1,20,000 and revenue from operation 14,40,000. Yes, correct. Provision for doubtful debts 20,000 we do not consider because it reduces our sale and it is internal arrangement. Calculate trade receivable turnover ratio. Now formula of trade receivable turnover ratio is net credit sales upon average trade receivable. With the given information, net credit sales we are not able to calculate. So in this condition we will consider this net sales as net credit sales. 14,40,000. Only closing trade receivable is given. Opening trade receivable is not given. So this closing trade receivable will be considered as average trade receivable. So 1,20,000. 12 12 144. It means 12 times. The trade receivable turnover ratio is 12 times. Company is able to generate sales 12 times in 1 year with the given resources. I hope it is clear to everyone. Let's see one more question. Question number 92. Question number 92. Closing trade receivable is given 4 lakh. Closing trade receivable is given 4 lakh. Cash sales is 25% of credit sales. So suppose credit sales, we assume X. So cash sales is 25% of credit sales. So 25% of credit sales means X by 4. Excess of closing trade receivable over opening trade receivable is 2 lakh. It means opening trade receivable is 4 lakh minus 2 lakh is equal to 2 lakh according to the given information. So opening trade receivable 2, closing is 4, and closing is excess by 2 lakh by from opening. And what is given? Revenue from operation net sales is given 15 lakh. Revenue from operation, which is known as net sales, it is given 15 lakh. Right? Yes, 15 lakh is given. Calculate trade receivable turnover ratio. We need to calculate trade receivable turnover ratio with the given information. Trade receivable turnover ratio means net credit sales upon average trade receivable. So we need to calculate credit sales. Credit sales is not given, cash sales is not given, but revenue from operation is given, means total sales is given. We know that credit sales plus cash sales is equal to total sales. So first we calculate credit sales. Credit sales plus cash sales is equal to total sales. Now credit sales we have assumed X and cash sales is 25%, means X by 4 is equal to total sales. Total sales is 15 lakh. Now when we solve this, we will get credit sales very easily. X plus X by 4 is equal to 5X by 4 is equal to 15 lakh. And X will be, now by using cross multiplication, 4 into 15 lakh divide by 5. 5, 3 is 15, 3, 4 is 12. It means 12 lakh. Yes or no? So X is your credit sales, and your credit sales we have computed, that is 12 lakh. Now what is required? Now average trade receivable is required. So working note number 2. Average trade receivable means opening trade receivable plus closing trade receivable divided by 2. So opening is 2 and closing is 4 lakh. Opening trade receivable plus closing trade receivable divide by 2. 2 plus 4 is 6 lakh. 6 lakh divided by 2 lakh is 3 lakh. So average trade receivable is 3 lakh. Now 12 by 3, we can easily put values in the formula. 12 lakh net credit sales upon 3 lakh is equal to 4 times. So trade receivable turnover ratio is 4 times. I hope the question is clear to everyone. So let's do next. Hello? Question number 93. Yes. Question number 93. A firm normally has trade receivable equal to 2 month credit sales. Okay. During the coming year, it expects credit sales of 720,000 spread evenly over the year 12 month. Okay, so question number 93. So credit sales is expected 7,20,000. One thing is given. And what is the estimated amount of trade receivable at the end of the year? We need to calculate closing trade receivables. This is what we need to calculate. Amount of trade receivable at the end of the year. And one more information is given. That trade receivable equal to 2 month credit sales. What does it mean? 2 month credit sales. In a year, how many months are there? In a year, there are 12 months. And they have a trade receivable equal to 2 months. Means in every 2 months, they get their money back. Isn't it? Yes or no? So you can calculate trade receivable turnover ratio. In 1 year, there is 12 months. And here it is mentioned that firm normally has trade receivable equal to 2 month credit sales. So the time of trade receivable is 2 months. So when we divide it, we get trade receivable turnover ratio. It means 6 times. This is another way to calculate trade receivable turnover ratio. This is debt collection period and this is month in a year. So 6 times trade receivable turnover ratio. Okay, so you can see we have formula of trade receivable turnover ratio. One more formula. What is that formula? That is net credit sales upon average trade receivable. Yes or no? So net credit sales is given in the question, 7,20,000. Average trade receivable is not given. But trade receivable turnover ratio we have computed 6 times with the given information. So by using this now we can easily calculate average trade receivable. How can we calculate? 7,20,000 divided by 6, that is 1,20,000. So that 1,20,000 is your closing trade receivable. Estimated amount of closing trade receivable. Is that clear to everyone? I hope it is clear. Closing trade receivable is now 1,20,000. Estimated amount of closing trade receivable. Okay, so let's move on next. Wait a minute. Okay, question number 94. Mercury Limited has credit sales of 4 lakh Mercury Limited has credit sale of rupees 4 lakh If the collection period is 36 days, very good. Collection period is given. 36 days, it means after every 36 days they get their money. Year is assumed to be 360 days. Calculate trade receivable turnover ratio. First point, we need to calculate trade receivable turnover ratio. So there is one more formula, number of days in year upon debt collection period. This is one more formula to calculate trade receivable turnover ratio. Debt collection period. So number of days in a year is 360 and the collection period is 36. So it means 36 into 10, 10 times. So trade receivable turnover ratio is 10 times. We are able to generate sales 10 times. First point. Now you need to calculate average trade receivable with the given information. यू कैन सी ट्रेड रिसीवेबल टर्नओवर रेशियो वी हैव एंड क्रेडिट सेल्स वी हैव, है ना। ट्रेड रिसीवेबल टर्नओवर रेशियो वी हैव वन मोर फॉर्मूला, नेट क्रेडिट सेल्स अपॉन एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल, है ना। बाय पुटिंग वैल्यूज इन दिस फॉर्मूला 10, नेट क्रेडिट सेल्स इज गिवन 4 लाख, है ना, डिवाइड बाय एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल। सो व्हाट विल बी एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल? एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल विल बी 4 लाख डिवाइड बाय 10, 40,000। यस और नो, सी द क्वेश्चन। ट्रेड रिसीवेबल एट द एंड, व्हेन ट्रेड रिसीवेबल एट द एंड आर मोर देन दैट इन द बिगिनिंग। ओके, सपोज ओपनिंग ट्रेड रिसीवेबल इज एक्स, देन क्लोजिंग ट्रेड रिसीवेबल विल बी मोर बाय 6,000, सो एक्स प्लस 6,000। दिस इज अकॉर्डिंग टू गिवन इंफॉर्मेशन। वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट क्लोजिंग ट्रेड रिसीवेबल, है ना। एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल इज 40,000, वी हैव कंप्यूटेड एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल। देयर इज फॉर्मूला ऑफ एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल, ओपनिंग ट्रेड रिसीवेबल प्लस क्लोजिंग ट्रेड रिसीवेबल डिवाइड बाय 2। एवरेज ट्रेड रिसीवेबल वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्यूटेड, दैट इज 40,000। ओपनिंग ट्रेड रिसीवेबल इज एक्स, क्लोजिंग ट्रेड रिसीवेबल इज x plus 6,000, है ना, divide by 2, let us cross multiply, 42 जा 80,000, x plus x 2x plus 6,000, then 2x is equal to 80 minus 6, 74,000, x will be 74,000 divide by 2, 37,000. So your opening trade receivable is equal to 37,000 and closing trade receivable is equal to x plus 6,000 or 37,000 plus 6,000 is equal to 43,000. So I hope this question is clear to everyone.
Yes, sir.